And now, The Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
You got to do it just like that. Wednesday evening in New York City, it's The Bonfire. Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. Big J. Oakerson here. That's Dan Soder over there.
Hi.
We both have a light brown drink in front of us.
Yes, we do. We both have sports paraphernalia on the elevator up. It looked like we were going to a sports show.
You have Sirius cream in your coffee.
I got you. Well, the dude from Dunkin' Donuts near Sirius, sometimes, as I've described to Jay, puts
racism.
A disrespectful amount of cream into my iced coffee. Where one time Jay thought I just had a white styrofoam cup. That's how much cream was in it.
And the guy, yeah, I thought you did. I thought you got like a fountain soda.
No, the guy really jazzes it up when I go in. He does like the, what's up, buddy? How you doing? What's going on? I'm like, hey. And he's like, and I'm like, ah. So last time I went in, I was like, can I get a little bit of cream on Monday? And he did it.
Did you hear the Philly commandment? I said fountain soda.
Fountain soda.
Did you guys catch that at all?
No. Did you slip out of it?
It was weird. I went fountain soda.
Is it a full moon? Are you transforming?
Get away.
Now go down by the water.
Jacob, Christine, Lou all here, and then serving his last day as a Bonfire producer.
The last day on the show. Merkface Andy. It's time for him to go to that war in the sky.
Christine just put up a message. Is that you?
Yeah.
Did you notice Patti LaBelle outside? Yeah. I talked about it for 3 minutes when we came to the studio.
I also like that Christine communicates with us like Ghost Rider, the TV show. Wait, we're getting a message.
Can you do that? Can you always write yours truly, Doogie Howser?
Yeah.
I always wish when I was younger that I had a friend that would crawl in and out of my window of my room.
Yeah, then you actually think of it happening in reality, and it would be very bothersome.
Your friend can do it? That means any...
But also, you just do it where you're like, dude, we're teenage boys. I'm jerking off.
Dude,
he goes, hey, Doogie.
I put a sign on the window that says knock.
Hey, Doogs.
It's me, Vinny.
It's me, Vin.
I'm the only culture you have in this white neighborhood.
I give you a little, I keep you grounded while you're out there doing doctor stuff.
You know, you help me, you know, experiment on small animals because I'm clearly a future serial killer.
Hey, dogs, you know, if you're milling around, you find yourself milling around the organs or something.
Hey,
maybe you bring one back for me.
Hey, dogs, I got this weird question for you. You know a way that I can make a guy, like, paralyzed by cutting something on the back of his neck or something? This 10th grader owes me a little bit of scratch.
Hey, Duke, you plowing out Wander yet or what?
Yeah, dude. Hey, Duke, listen, I know you're a doctor. I heard they got these dick pills. You ain't got that blood disease that ain't got no name yet, right?
Yo, Duke, do me a favor. If you could beat me, if you could page me when you get ready to give it the old brajoots,
yeah.
Call me up and I'll come over right by the window.
Hey, you're always typing in that fucking computer. Real quick question. You got access to opiates? What can you do, huh?
Dukes, what's the word on fentanyl at your hospital? Dukes.
He's just trying to cop.
Dukes, I got an uncle that'll pay real, real big if you can get us some Oxy 30.
What do you think? They're going to be like, oh, the child doctor fucking smuggled the drugs.
He went, that guy's a kid.
He's a good kid. He's fucking a heart surgeon. He's 14 years old. What is he? Stealing opiates? Get the fuck out of here.
Dude, if they said, we got you the best surgeon in the world to do your heart surgery and a 14-year-old kid walks
so
in, I would chop him in the throat.
I'd make this. Who's fucking with me? Has the medication.
I would take his wrist and beat his surgery hands on metal so they were destroyed.
You'd be like, hold on. Actually, here comes Dr. Hauser for you.
This is a fucking joke right now.
Who is he? I've got three blocked arteries. Who is he? You're going to stress me out. You're going to kill me on this table.
He's like, mister, you don't understand. I'm so dope in heart surgery.
Listen, this surgery is going to be lit. You mind if I put this on my Insta story? Just a modern Doogie Howser.
Modern Dukes?
Modern Doogie Howser is just a shithead. He goes, hey, what's up? We're getting turnt in the OR. Hey.
Oh, shit's getting turnt in the OR.
Skrillex does the remix of the song where it's like...
Doogie Howser.
Let the beat drop. Let it.
Hey, what's up? I'm Doogie Howser. I'm a 14-year-old boy that doesn't care.
Oh! 16-year-old
look who's
boy genius.
Showing up late.
Speaking of the 14-year-old boy genius.
Hey, Mark Norman.
It's Mark Norman, everybody.
Hey, you're
Mark Norman joining us for the whole show today.
Yeah, you want to know why? Because this motherfucker's got an awesome Comedy Central Hour special coming out Friday.
Yeah.
Make sure you DVR it. Don't Be Yourself, premiering this Friday, March 12th at midnight on Comedy Central.
Oh, yeah. You guys had one.
Yeah.
So we're all in the same fam.
Hey, welcome, buddy. We're all Eskimo brothers.
Did you get your blazer when you walked in?
What's that?
Did you get your membership blazer when you walked in?
Did Colin Quinn put it on you? He goes, I'm fucking welcome to the family.
All right, I guess you're funny enough. You got to...
We were just talking about Doogie Howser, if they did a modern version, a millennial Doogie Howser, how awful it would be.
Well, he'd be black.
Oh, true.
Most certainly.
Yeah.
You know, 24, that.
And Doogie, oh my God. By the way, Doogie makes much more sense on a black dude.
I hate...
Yes! His name's Doogie.
They go, I do. They go, Douglas? He goes, Doogie.
Doogie, please. I mean, now, I don't mean to get all time to kill on you guys right now.
Oh, God.
But I just did this whole thing where I was like, could you imagine if you're going in there for a serious heart surgery and they bring in your doctor and it's a 14-year-old kid? I go, you'd lose your shit. Now, picture he's black.
Ah.
But I like that you go, I want y'all to shut your eyes.
Shut your eyes.
Nah, you're laying on a table. Your heart hurts. This is your only shot at getting out. And who walks in? A little boy. Now imagine that little boy. It's black. It's black.
No!
Can I just say, as a Southerner, the courtrooms there have air conditioning.
Okay.
I just
want to
snip that in the bud.
Yeah, they always throw that under you guys, that you don't have properly ventilated courtrooms.
Yeah, there's a lot of damping, that forehead, losing the tie.
Well, we lost the air conditioning technology to the Yankees in the Civil War.
Right,
they stole the blueprints.
They got our blacks and our fans.
Motorized fans and our help.
Yeah, a lot of mustache sweat in every Southern courtroom.
There's always one fan, but it's just super slow.
Creaky in here.
Yeah.
So I went to the Giants-Mets game today. Day game, which is always fun.
Nice.
My seats were up, but they were behind home plate, but like up where the net stopped.
Yes.
The backing net. Top of the second inning, Buster Posey, my favorite Giant, is up. Second pitch, he line drive backwards, and the fucking kid catches it barehanded. Caught a foul ball barehanded.
Get out of here! Holy shit!
Swear to God. It fucking was coming right at my friend and my girlfriend's face, and I barely sat up. I just reached up and grabbed it. The section went nuts. It was one of the craziest things. So I'm DVRing the game to see if it was on SNY.
Yeah.
Because Buster Posey hit a home run the next pitch. Was a home run. But,
wow, what an exciting back-to-back things that happened.
Dude, like,
your fucking hand is killing you.
Dude, I did a thing where
back-to-back things.
Yeah, but I caught it, and then everyone was like, the guy in front of me reacted. I was like in shock, because I just like, whap, and I just caught it, and the guy goes, bah, and I was like, oh, and then everyone was like, going nuts, but then I jokingly like grabbed my hand, like, bah, and everyone was like, are you okay? I'm like, oh yeah, and I was just fucking around. My hand's fine.
Uh-huh.
But it was crazy. The rest of the game, everyone was like,
really?
That's killer.
Really?
What
iron hands? Didn't hurt at all?
I mean, it hurts right here.
My driver came at you, you said.
It hurts right here. This is the only part that hurts of my hand, but it's like the tip, like the bottom of my...
Would have been fucking
index.
Really cool if you tried to turn double play, like you catch it bare hand, just skip it to the fucking first base.
Rookie of the year, that shit. Just fire it from the stands. And they're like, we gotta hire this kid.
Funky butt loving.
Yeah.
Yeah, nothing. I've never even caught a t-shirt gun t-shirt.
Me neither.
Oh, dude.
I've never got... Well, by the way, speaking of t-shirt guns, Sal Volcano, when we did Impractical Jokers in Newark...
No, not Newark. That was Camden.
Camden. We got to shoot the gun.
Murder rate. You're not the only one.
Oh, yeah. t-shirt cannon's great.
I got a nightmare story about the t-shirt cannon. I went to a basketball game with Joe List in D.C., Georgetown.
Yeah.
And I locked eyes with the t-shirt guy. He shot it to me. I jump up, and it goes right through my hands and lands in the guy's lap behind me. He goes, jeez, I can't believe how easy that was. And like these two like black girls were next to me. They're like, damn, he missed that shit. I was like, oh, and Joe went fucking nuts. He never let me live it down. He called Louie. We're opening for Louie. I had to tell Louie the whole thing. That was brutal.
So you have to go to a comedy, one of your comedy heroes, and be like, I missed.
Yes. It looked right. It was for me, and I lost it. Boy, that haunts you as a man.
I've never had the opposite. I've never caught a foul ball. I've never even came close. And for that to happen the way it did, by the way, Murkface said he caught two foul balls.
I have.
What?
I've
caught two.
Oh, shit.
But you know what's the best part?
I'm not trying to upstage you. I have.
There's two things, though. There was a guy.
By the way, they were the same time with both hands.
He goes, from two different games.
Both hats. You had two hats in your hand.
And he goes, and then he crushed him in the dust.
Paul knew he was going to have to catch bubble. He's
like, buy this, Todd McFarlane.
So they, the best part was there was a guy two rows in front of me with a glove that was just super bummed the rest of the game.
There's nothing worse than taking home a useless glove. When you go to the game, you come with so much promise. Right. When you're going home, you're like, now I got to carry this stupid glove. I can't even decide to go to a restaurant without bringing a glove in with me.
Yeah, and then there was another foul ball later, and a guy over in the section tries barehanding it and missed, and ooh, it like went off. And he's like, my buddy Eli was like, oh man, I think you got in that dude's head. He's like trying to catch it. It was crazy. I've never experienced anything like that.
That's so cool.
There's some kid with cancer going, shucks.
Yeah.
You know?
I looked around and I was glad there was no little kids around because I got to keep it and not look like a dickhead.
Dude.
Good
keep it either way.
Yeah, no. You're right.
Fuck show it to kids. Him. Put it right in his face.
I go like this. I earned this.
Those kids are
33
be...
years on this motherfucking planet.
Those kids are going to be shitty anyway.
Yeah, right? They don't need a foul ball. I need
a
foul
ball. You went to like a businessman's game, though.
Yeah, it was a business. Well, there was like, you could tell there was kids, like there was like groups of like classes coming out because it's the last week of school and businessmen.
Huh. It's a good group.
Yeah. There was no kids near you.
There was one little kid down, this Giants fan, another Giants fan, this little kid, and he kept giving me like puppy dog eyes.
Did you show it to him? Like,
I walked by him and I was like, why? I almost like got mad at him. Like, why are you giving me puppy dog? I'm not going to give you my foul ball.
Now, where's
my foul ball?
It's at home.
Oh, that's fun.
But here, I'll show you the picture.
I believe you. I just, you know.
It was crazy.
I keep it on me all day.
Yeah, I want to see it.
But I want to know if because a lot of times some foul balls, they go, and that's going in the crowd. Or if they were like, it went back. Because it was like, it like came back and
look at the head on that kid who reeled in that ball.
Oh my, that man boy has paws like a grizzly bear. That is insane. See?
There it is. Wow.
Yeah.
How about that?
Let me see.
It's a real ball. That's exciting.
Yeah, I was pretty pumped about it.
Dan, you photographed like the guy who was the star of the movie Grandma's Boy.
Thank you so much. I like him.
I like him too, but you're way handsomer than he is.
Oh,
it was an insult.
No, you're just trying to fuck.
But I mean, in person.
Oh, you can't say, oh, on a picture, I'm a six in person. A 9-5, 9-5. So yeah, that was the coolest sports moment for me.
Can I ask a shitty question?
Yeah.
You're not going to like it.
No, I know. It's dead dad stuff, probably.
No.
Oh, okay.
Geez. Wow.
All right.
You think your dad was looking down on you and did this?
Yeah.
Right.
Felt like that.
Thumbs
up. It's the first time I felt like I caught my father's love.
He did this to you? His ghost appeared and went.
He was in the angels in the outfield, but
yeah,
if it was the dead dad, not
hat tip.
Yeah. He goes, son, that's why I left your mother, so you could become this man. I go, well, it seems like it was like self-serving reasons, like you liked alcohol.
But that's what I was going to say. The day game probably got to be the hardest to not have a cold American beer.
1,000%.
I figured.
The toughest place not to drink is a day baseball game.
It's got
to
be hard. The first time
I felt it, there was a big group of comics that went about 3 years ago.
Yeah.
I'd already quit drinking about a year at that point. It was a big group, 20 group. It was hot.
Yeah.
And it was during the day, and I saw someone had like one of those big 20-ouncers, and it spilled over his wrist.
Oh.
And I was like, that looks fucking good.
Yeah.
And then I heard that they serve some St. Pauli's girl, non-alcoholic, I think at Yankee Stadium.
Oh, that's interesting.
Yeah.
That's fucking hilarious.
Now, would you get that, the NA?
Yeah, absolutely. I had one up in Canada. I was hanging out with Bert Kreischer, and he drinks. And the guy was like,
Kreischer drinks?
Yeah, I don't know if you guys know this. But he's like the most fun to hang out with, but bars are tough for me because I don't drink.
Yeah.
And then this guy gave me this thing called Erdinger. Erdinger alcohol-free beer, and it tasted fucking great.
When you were at the game with all the comics and they started the beers, like, do they take on a much more dramatic, like, thing for you? Do you know what I mean? Like, that's what I'm saying, where you're like, it's like, Dan, you want me to grab you? Oh, I forgot you're not drinking.
Yeah. That's great. Yeah, it's like...
Pour it into your mouth
and then it's like, choo-choo! Guys, there's a train outside and it's Coors Light.
It's the bullet train.
Oh, it's hot, but now it's cold and everyone's happy.
There's no bikinis, though.
Oh. Hey, look, it's everyone you've ever upset back for a party. All you gotta do is drink. And I'm like, just standing there like.
And the ghost of your dad says, no son of mine's going to be some fag with a glove.
And he goes.
He's barehanded it.
He goes, that's why I left you to toughen you up to barehand a foul ball, pal.
Pal.
I got to go back. There's a party up in heaven.
Your dad's Sam Elliott.
Yeah. All right, son.
I got to head back. I got a chick up there that's going to polish my knob if I buy her a drink.
I got a lady from the Renaissance that said she's going to suck me off 15th century style.
Now hand me an Urbinger.
Yeah, Urbinger. Give me an Urbinger. By the way, you can still smoke everywhere up there. Just ripping Marlboro Reds. That's such a dead dad cigarette, Marlboro Reds.
No.
That's what he did.
Oh, Marlboro Miles for days.
How many cigarettes a day do you think he actually pulled out?
Two packs a day.
No, but how many things he pulled out with his fingers, or did he do? Was he big on like the?
Oh, no, soft pack.
Shake the pack.
The shake.
No, you know
oh,
what?
Yeah.
You know what he'd do? He'd do hard pack. Actually, he did do soft pack, and I was always impressed because he put them in the back pocket of his OPs. Uh-huh. They never broke.
Wow.
He was always pulling them because I remember when
low
they were like
pockets.
Smashed out. Oh, my mom's boyfriend Joe smoked Marlboro Reds in soft pack, but my dad would sometimes do hard pack, flip open with one hand, pop it, you know, like,
all one hand.
And then just put it in his mouth and with the lighter in his left, like, well, you know.
My point being, wherever it is, the cigarette leaves the pack in his mouth.
Oh, 1,000%.
Right. Yeah. You ever see the person who opens it and just actually gets one out,
yeah.
Like riding like the thing up
yes.
their face almost?
Yeah, it's awkward.
Oh. It's a weird one too. Yeah,
it is.
When you're like too committed. Like,
my favorite.
You've worked on your style of smoking.
My favorite is the soft pack when they flick the bottom and it jumps out the pack into the mouth. And they like.
Well, that just sounds like fucking
douchebaggery.
America's got talent magic. Honestly, what?
Oh, you just gotta
flick the pack and it jumps into your thing.
No, you take the bottom.
The person that can flick the card,
but it's like a soft pack, and you flick it with your middle finger, and it pops out of the soft pack.
Come on, if you saw that in an action movie, go get out of here.
Nah, I mean, yeah, but then you do it, and you're like, I feel like I'm in an action movie.
I've never seen that. What about the guy who lights two for the girl, one for you, one for the girl?
Yeah.
That was a good look.
That was a good look.
Yeah.
You can't do that anymore. Smoking's fucking gone. You guys are pretty badass.
Dude, the people you meet, though. Just last weekend in Boston, I met a guy. I think he's a local comic and magician.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not going to judge his overall magic at all. And he even said, he goes, I would never
judge his sorcery.
Goes, no, but I go, dude, I'm a real sucker for magic. He goes, all right, well, here's an easy one. And he did like the red ball. And he like put it in my hand and did and he's just like, you know, now here's my red ball, but now, oh, look, they're both in your hand kind of thing. And it's like, I just like saw every single thing that happened. Like, I saw every bit of it. I'm like, now when he opens his hand, there's nothing in it. I have to go, what? And he's like, and I'm just kind of like, yeah, no, they're both in my hand. He's like, and he taps my fingers to like open my fan. I go, no, no. What? And then, it goes, then, he goes, yeah, and then he goes, if you hang around after the show, he goes, I'll get my deck of cards. I'll show you some really cool shit. And then I'm kind of like, I don't know if I want to see it now.
Yeah.
Mm. I saw every piece of that.
That's sad. That you have to lie to the magician.
That's never happened in my life before.
Oof.
What, that you've seen it happen?
I watched the whole thing happen. I saw everything that was happening.
I've seen that with children.
Now, one thing I know is, like, I do actually enjoy magic, is that the... I pay attention to all the times they're touching you, because that's most of it.
Yeah.
Most of that kind of stuff is like they're touching you so many places.
Yeah.
Like he's squeezing.
Don't touch me, please don't touch me.
He's squeezing this hand for no reason because he's very firmly putting the other second ball into your hand. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah,
like that kind of thing. Spoiler alert.
Right.
Everybody out there listening.
But how would you not feel that? I'm not a big touchy magician guy.
I always can't believe when someone gets their watch. That's never happened to me, but I'm like, but you watch it happen. There's
all
videos
the
of it. It's
all
fucking
the time.
Crazy.
I want someone to steal your watch off of you. I want it to happen because do you think they do it with your watch?
Hey guys, look.
Oh man, if that happened, I'd be like, Mark Norman is the devil.
I've never seen it done live where I've believed it ever.
Yeah. David Blaine's pretty snazzy with it.
Yeah, he does it. But it's like, you know, I was saying, it's something where he's like, let your hands go loose. And it's like, you know, I'm going to shake him out and say the magic words. While he's doing this, he's just like unhooking his thing.
All right, give me one more second. Bad at that trick. Yeah. All right, keep shaking.
Say Alakazam, Alakazoo. Uh-huh. Say Shazam, Shabazzle.
Look over.
I'll say, close your eyes.
Give me your arm.
How do you work this hook?
God, this watch is a tough one, huh?
Kind of a clasp is this thing.
Do you put this on every morning? You have to sleep in this thing, right? This is tough.
To go back to the cigs for a second, because I feel like 90s kid, that was a big part of it. House parties.
Yeah.
You always see kids packing and, you know, sitting shotgun packing all day.
The best was in comedy clubs when I first started, and you would hear packing of cigarettes, and you'd think it was clapping.
How about the pride people felt?
Nate has a great story about that.
The pride people felt in packing cigarettes.
Yeah, it was big.
But people that were like, no, let me pack them.
Yes. I could pack them. Right.
Because like the tobacco would be like, a half an inch into the paper. I'm like, why do I don't want that to be the case.
Can I also say this? It made it harder to smoke the cigarettes.
Oh, is that right?
Because they're fucking packed in there. So you're like... Just fucking ripping.
Flame won't travel through.
God damn. Mitch is great at packing these cigs.
It's like trying to drink a shamrock shake.
Too thick.
Getting this headache.
And I never smoked, but there was a lot of this shit going on with the, hey man, can I bum one? Only got one left or two left. It was always two left and one was a lucky one. I didn't know what was going
on. The lucky
there.
One the lucky third one from the left. Bigger. Flip it over.
Come on. Yeah, it.
That was real.
When I was in eighth grade.
You stopped doing it as an adult?
Yes.
I swear to God.
I
believe every time I buy a pack of cigarettes, I have to stop Christine from making a wish.
But I get it. Really? I get it. But I get it because I did it in eighth grade.
I didn't even see that.
But I, in like eighth grade, I did it when I smoked. When I got a pack of cigarettes in eighth grade, it was the equivalent of having $100 cash. We're like, I have so many cigarettes. It's such a dirtbag thing to do. But this kid, I remember this sixth grader named Mikey who lived near our bus stop. He would steal packs of Benson and Hedges from his... By the way, He was smoking in sixth grade. We were in eighth grade.
I know, but man, really come from a garbage town.
No.
It's like that kind.
Just that no was garbagey. No.
Yeah, dude.
All right.
There was a lot of trampolines, not even like full four-people trampolines, like the one you just bought yourself.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, one spring was broken.
Yeah.
At the Dickinson house. I can tell you exactly where that was.
They had a dog that would bark too loud when you walked by.
Dude, my
I grew up like around. Like in city kind of garbage, but you really had like
suburban
like
boredom
suburban
garbage.
Garbage.
Dude, eighth grade, they used to do smash and grabs where they'd run into gas stations and cigarettes were still on the counter then.
Mm-hmm.
Like cigarettes were on the fucking counter. Like they weren't behind the register. They were like, you could walk up and be like, oh, a pack of cigarettes like that. And these fucking dirtbags would run in and just grab packs of cigarettes. And the guy at Mini Stop had a fucking bat under going, no! Just hear them yelling and fucking whacking at their young forearms.
Yeah.
But then I was always the pussy.
Not you, Doogie. You were home.
No, I was actually outside on my mongoose bike waiting for him. And then they'd come out and they'd be like, I bum one. And they're like, pussy odor. You wouldn't even go in there and do it. I'm like, I don't want to do it, but can I bum one?
Thanks for doing the work, boys.
Thanks for doing all the hard work. I'm sorry. I see myself as more of a COO in this whole situation.
I'm lookout, dude.
I'm more big picture guy.
We do that. We call it Yahoos. You grab a case in both hands and you go Yahoo and you run out.
Why do you have to have a catchphrase?
Because we were idiots. It made it more silly.
But you grew
it
up.
It made it more terrible. You really let them know it.
Right.
There was no sneakiness to it at all.
But Norman, you growing up in the French Quarter, you're around booze a lot more.
Yeah.
I think like booze for me didn't hit until high school. Eighth grade, some kids, it was weed and booze hit at the same time.
Yeah, we started early. One time we hit this place called Soap and Suds. That was the name of the corner store. And it would always be one guy to talk to the guy, like, which way is Maple Street, buddy? And they would go, well, let me pull out a map here. And then you'd run out. But we did it, and it was Paul Parnell. Big fat kid, great guy, and he went up and he was like, hey man, how do I get to, Treme Avenue or whatever, and the guy would be like, well, I don't know, and he was looking at us, and we just ran out, and he put his hand on Paul, and he's like, you're not going anywhere, and he's like, oh, come on, I don't know them, we're all the same age, we're wearing, like, high school uniforms, and he's like, I don't know those fucking weirdos, and he pulled out a gun, he said, I'm not letting you leave until you tell me all their names, so we don't know what's happening, we're all out there, you know, we're in the back of a truck, like, half a mile away, like, where the hell's Paul, what the hell, like, a half hour goes by or something like that, so we go back in that area, and we see Paul running out of the store with a Korean guy chasing with a gun.
That's
and
fucking...
And we go, oh, shit! And we all left.
You guys left him?
Yeah, we saw Paul like 2 weeks later.
And now, that's funny. Paul goes,
That's all it took him to get home.
Yeah.
I've been, dude, I'm telling you, when I got a bunch of friends, like, tied up into a thing where we had to actually fight was in high school. We went down to like the other kids' neighborhood.
Yeah. Because you're a city kid, so you kind of have those different neighborhoods.
And we were kind of like, and it was kind of, I think because like my part of the neighborhood was much more like good kids.
Yeah.
And the down the hill kids were more like the rough kids. Or just like the more like degenerate kids, you know what I mean? Like that would do stuff. So we were like, no, we're pretty cool too. Let's go down there and just like, you know, let our presence be known. And we just kind of hung out like across the street from them.
Yeah.
And they just also hung with like much older people too. So they got like 22-year-olds, 23-year-olds with them. And the guys have beards and tats already. And none of us are there. I'm talking about we're like 14, 15.
Oh, but that's what I'm saying. When 14-year-olds, the group of friends I was in middle school and eighth grade were hanging out with 16 and 17-year-olds and we were like 12 and 13. And even then I was like, this is very uncomfortable. These kids are old. So I know what you're talking about because I was in that group.
So I'm with the
older kids, where you're like,
I'm with the good kids. And then you're kind of like, so what happened was like, they sort of noticed we were hanging out across the street and they all stood up. As soon as they stood up, we were just kind of like, just get out of here, guys. Whatever. So we start walking, and they start walking. And then we start walking faster. They start walking faster, and now there's like a light jog happening.
Oh.
And as the jogging's happening, I notice my friends are getting further away from me, and these guys are getting closer to me, particularly.
Uh-oh.
And when it just becomes the point where I'm like, these guys are going to catch me. I'm just too slow.
Yeah.
I just had to think. They're like, what's up, dude? Like, what's going on? I go, nothing. Why? What's up? And I start going like, guys, they just want to talk.
No.
And my friends all had to come back. And then like another one of my friends actually ended up getting into the fight that night, like a fist fight. And they were gone, but I had to drag them all back. Yeah, so I'm like, guys, hold on.
Guys,
it's cool. You guys want to talk? See what's up?
No, guys, we're hashing it out. There was this kid in my high school that was fucking terrifying, but he was like a full on wigger. Like he was a full on wigger. Like would put Afro sheen in his white hair.
Damn.
Like,
sickle cell.
he wanted to be black so bad he went and infected himself with sickle cell. He goes, doctor, you sure this gonna do this to me? But he hung out with this terrifying Mexican dude named Spider.
Who had
a Cadillac, a gold Cadillac. And my freshman year of high school, my buddy who's the coach for the San Francisco 49ers, me and my other friend Dennis are sitting on his driveway. And it's in the middle of the night. In a nice neighborhood, and we see that Cadillac go by, and we're like, is that Spider's Cadillac? And it goes left up the opposite side of the street, and it's driving up, and it just goes out of nowhere, just like, and just does a U-turn. It starts coming towards us, and we're like, what the fuck? And it just starts driving towards Mike's house, and we're on the driveway, and we're like, what the fuck? It comes across the busy street, and then up the driveway, and we're like, and all three of us run and jump over the back fence. They fucking chase us into his backyard. He shut the back door of his house, and fucking Andy, the wigger kid, is right there with Spider behind him, and we're like, and he locks the door, and they fucking went out front and left. We never talked to him. We never had any indication of what happened.
I can put
two of my friends on the phone that will swear to God that happened. It was one of the most terrifying things. And I was like 14, and I was like, do I have to worry about going to school on Monday?
Right.
It happened on like Saturday, and you're like, I might be dead at school. Like they might see me and be like, I want to. But I think they were just like trying to scare us.
Yeah.
But it was fucking terrifying.
Jesus.
Spider's fucking Cadillac. It was an old one, old crusty one, like ran on diesel, so it's like, and like came over. Ah, dude, it was.
When they're on your property, they're in your world now. You know, it's violating.
Yeah, it was like a monster coming out of a TV.
Yes,
that's how
exactly.
It felt.
I told you, in my world of like growing up, when I thought I could be more like when the older kids would kind of fuck with you.
Yeah.
And I became an older kid. I remember going to the wing of the school that was the younger kids and I was like, some redheaded kid walked by and I just shit on him. I forget even what I said.
You know,
I was like, move little motherfucker or something like that. He turned around and he's like, fuck you, fucking asshole. And I was just like, there's nothing I can do. He's a young little kid. Why didn't I think of that when I was a child?
Oh, dude, this fucking terrifying kid, he was like, just remember in high school, just the year difference, how much older they felt?
Like
1 year, and you're like, you're an adult, I'm a child.
Right.
This guy who I ended up becoming friends with, Brian Costello, that went to my high school, he was like on varsity football as a sophomore, and I was a freshman, and I remember being at like a pack of lockers and being like, hey, isn't you? And he did the thing where he just made fun of my voice. He goes, and I was like,
that crushes me.
Terrified of him. Like, he had a goatee as a sophomore, and I was like, I can't say anything. I remember walking to U.S. History just being like, I just got bitched out by Brian Costello. And sitting there, and it felt like an older man was like, you fucking suck.
Isn't it funny how the age gap moves for what you're most afraid of? Like, when you're 15, you would never want to fight a 25-year-old.
Mm-hmm.
But like, you know, I'm 40 now. Like, yeah. I'd much rather fight a 50-year-old than like a 30-year-old.
Of course. Oh, yeah.
I wouldn't want to fight a 21-year-old. No, I wouldn't want to fight a fucking 15-year-old. Yeah. These kids that get on the train in New York City out of their fucking schools.
Oh,
I'm like,
God.
The fuck, I'll give you guys all my money. I don't want to fight
15-year-olds have beards and shit. Yeah. Though.
Right.
I got to start doing stretches in the morning. I'm 33.
I mean, so like,
my hips lock up.
That one kid like beat up Cat Williams like a couple of months ago. Remember that? He was like 14.
Cause this group of kids.
I forgot that. He goes, this how y'all treat celebrities in your neighborhood.
Remember that when he dusted himself off? And he was like,
this how y'all, I come here pimping as a good, as a,
I come out here trying to play
I'm
know.
Coming over here as a disciple, as a man trying to help another little man, and you're going to go and beat my ass,
oh,
pimping? You just fucked up an adult.
It was like a yard.
Yeah. That's no way to act, little boy.
First he goes, stay back, boy.
Yeah, he goes,
stay back,
there
little
is,
boy.
There
oh, you
is.
Got me by the head. Better let go. Seriously, it's a good sweatshirt.
Oh, that's amazing. That kid must have been the king of school for a
year. Oh, man.
Oh, why is it all slowed down where he's on fucking, like, yeah, hitting the dart with old school? You got a fucking dart in your neck. Hey, Kat, you got a seventh grader on your back.
Seventh grader.
You got a seventh grader on your back.
Things ever.
I come over here trying to help you pimping, and you get on my back and choke me out. You're like, get out my way, little boy.
Lucky that kid didn't start doing comedy. This is like a credit.
That is. You've recently seen your next comedian beating up Kat Williams.
Yeah. How many views on that puppy?
Keep it going for Daquan Thomas.
Oh, that's so... Well, he's all tired now. He's, hey, that's great.
I got out of jail, nigga. They probably didn't have my biggest
shoe. Hey. Yeah. Real funny before, bro. Yep. Hey, brother, he's hilarious, bro.
Yep.
Hey.
You're
going to have acne till you're 26. Are you just
getting the snaps with him? He goes, hey, you're going to have acne till you're 26. He goes, I tell you this right now, your shoes look like your mama bought them at Payless.
Yeah, it's all
Oh,
over.
You want to mix it up?
Oh, boy.
Hey. Oh, is this it?
Okay. Yeah, going back?
That kid's
Hold
like,
on.
Don't do it.
My mom works two jobs to get me Accutane, you piece of shit.
Yeah. I'm fighting hungry, because I am hungry. Hold on, is this it? Is this
yeah, that goes that.
Oh, is this like...
Oh! Rewind that.
What's up?
No boy.
He snuck him.
Hey, you better back up, Kat.
Or you can get your dumb ass move the fuck out my way, little boy.
Oh, what's up?
No boy, I told you.
Yeah, so I can't. Bad move.
He's wearing wide receiver's gloves. That's got to feel terrible.
That's a bad
move. You're wearing wide receiver's gloves as you're getting beat up?
As now I lay here getting beat up by a child, I realized my wide receiver gloves were a bad idea. I did not grip. In this situation.
You think he has that frailty power? Like if he takes off the gloves, that's his burden. Like if he touches you, he sees your sins.
Or he's like Rogue from X-Men, he takes all your powers.
I'm taking your blackness with my bare hand.
He goes, little boy, get away from me, little boy.
Yeah.
When I was a kid, I had two black friends, Marnette and Tony.
Yeah.
And they lived on the other side of town, and we went to the Black Mall to play video games, that's like arcade games.
Yeah, that's the Aurora Mall where the shooting happened.
Oh, is that the Black Mall?
That was the Black Mall.
Really?
Yeah, that's
oh,
why.
Oh, shit, I didn't know he shut up a black theater.
Yeah, they tried to renovate it. And...
A little gentrify.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well,
gentrified your movie theater
with bullets.
They started showing Twilight,
right, Bridget Jones,
Woody Allen flicks.
The it's Warrior Renaissance, an Aurora Renaissance,
Werner Herzog night. Fitzcarraldo is on.
It's a Fellini film festival.
They go, hey, what you doing tonight? Like, hey, well, I heard they got a Fellini film festival over there, Aurora Mall.
Oh shit, yo, they showing all them.
So your friends are across town.
Yeah, so we're at the Black Theater playing at the arcade game, and he's playing Street Fighter, and I'm like the hype man. I'm like, come on, Marnette, you got it, buddy. Yeah, get him. And this black guy turning, going, come on, Marnette, you got it, buddy. Oh, dude, it crushed me. Dude. I was like, I was done. I had to leave.
That is, people don't realize.
You know, it's someone telling you, I am not afraid of your reaction to me insulting you playing as the
worst one I ever had.
When a stranger does that?
When a stranger does that, you're like, the first time it ever happened.
Like a thug, too.
Oh, and when you know they can beat you up.
Right,
what's
right.
even worse is if you're a child and an adult does it to you. When I was 6 years old, I wrestled. Like I was on a wrestling team from when I was like 5, 6, and 7, and I lost a match, and I was crying in a tournament, and I was like crying because I lost, and it was like a hard match. And one of the dads of the kids on my wrestling team goes, "Oh, are you crying, baby?"
Oh,
and I was like,
God.
I, it stunned me out of crying. Where I was like, as a fucking 6 year old, I was like, really, bud?
You're
like, I mean, it's making me clench my fists irate now. Christine, did I say something to a guy one time? Aren't you the sour in a guy, like, do something, like, repeat something you said?
Oh, I'm gonna get all fired up thinking about that.
Something. Yeah, that changes.
I remember that.
I just remember being so,
I think,
like,
Liz was there for that too. Yeah.
I was crying, and I just remember, like, through the tears, him being like, and he was a Taekwondo instructor.
Oh my God, a Cobra Kai.
Yeah, and he's like,
he was
like,
karate.
He was like a, he looked Filipino. I think he was Filipino.
Filipino!
Yeah, he was like a little Asian dude, and he goes, oh, is the baby crying? And I was like, I look like, look around, like, are you talking about someone else? Because
wow.
I'm a child.
Yeah.
Also, don't you practice martial arts? Isn't that all about fucking balancing your emotions and shit?
Right.
Kind of monster.
You could have fucked him up with just one, my dad's dead. Yeah. You're like, oh shit, sorry, he, kid, you know, buy an ice cream.
The worst part is...
she just hugged him and said, stop touching my dick.
Yeah, you're right. The two worst parts were, I didn't think of the dick hug. Should have done that. Second worst part was, Gary was still alive. He's just ripping it in the Bay Area. Where I go, so well, my dad would be here, but right now he's getting drunk with a woman named Donna.
There'd be nothing worse than you sending your dad after this guy, and that guy Taekwondo kicks the living shit out of your father. Your dad comes back with a broken cigarette in his mouth, so he goes, he crushed my package.
Just the blood.
He goes, that guy was, lightning quick hands, man, is all I can say. Goes, the only reason I knew I was getting kicked is because I saw the kicks returning back to his body.
He goes, I'm not going to lie. He landed the first six on my party ball. And then the second two, he flattened my mustache.
He's got a bent cigarette.
That fight was over before it started. Yeah, this is what he's like. That fight was over before it started, Dan. I'm not going to lie. I came out of the gates talking shit for about 12, 13 seconds, man. And he just fucking ripped me a new one.
He goes, by the way, I got to talk to Trish. I think we're going to put you in soccer.
Yeah, he keeps calling him Bruce Lee.
He goes, I don't know if it was the booze, but I swear to God, that little dink had 40, 50 hands.
I don't know. I think that's the father of an octopus, because he hit me in angles I didn't even know were possible.
He goes, long story short, just avoid that block, Dan. He just tore through two generations of his family. I'm not prepared for him to go through three.
Hey, bud, if you could go find your sweatpants, I'm going to go out to the car and make a road soda. but he tapped me up something good.
He got me back for NAM.
Yeah.
He tapped me up something good.
Yeah, goes, all right, bud. I'll see you at the car. I got to get out of here. I'm a little embarrassed. Let's take our first break. Mark Norman hanging out the whole fucking show.
Hey, hey.
Want to know why? His brand new hour special on Comedy Central airing this Friday, May 12th at midnight. Don't be yourself. Make sure you fucking check it out. And we will be right back. It's the Bonfire.
Hey, campers, we've all taken extra jobs to earn some extra cash. Back in the day, I used to CD store,
oh, man,
delivering auto parts.
Again.
Huh?
I thought we were going to have fun again.
Yeah, that was very fun. No, this one's going straight.
Okay.
This one's going straight up. I got a better way you can earn extra money than the crappy ways I had to do it. It's so much easier today thanks to Uber. Uber's the ultimate side hustle. Driving with Uber is a new way you can earn extra cash whenever you want. It's not just another J-O-B. It's a totally flexible way to earn. You can turn it on and off just like your car. If you have a few spare hours here and there, drive with Uber. Have you ever wanted to be your own boss? Dan, I bet you'd make a great boss.
Thanks, dude.
Well, if you drove with Uber, you could be your own boss. If you're driving right now, you should be earning right now. I would do it. And Uber's Instant Pay makes every day payday. You can cash out straight from the app to your bank account up to 5 times a day. Listen, if you enjoy earning extra cash, if there's something special you'd like to buy, your car can start making you money. So go ahead, get your side hustle on. Sign up to drive with Uber today. Go to uber.com/drive now. That's uber.com/drive now. uber.com/drive now. Certain restrictions apply. See site for details. Ring's mission is to make neighborhoods safer. Today, over 1 million people use the amazing Ring video doorbell to help protect their homes. Ring knows home security begins at the front door, but it doesn't end there.
So now they're extending that same level of security to the rest of your home with the Ring Floodlight Cam. Just like Ring's amazing doorbell, Floodlight Cam is a motion-activated camera and a floodlight that connects right to your phone with HD video and two-way audio that lets you know the moment anyone steps on your property. See and speak to visitors, even set off an alarm right from your phone. When things go bump in the night, you'll immediately know what it is. Whether you're home or away, the Ring Floodlight Cam lets you keep an eye on your home from anywhere. Ring Floodlight offers the ultimate in home security with high visibility floodlights and a powerful HD camera that puts security in your hands. With Ring, you're always home. Save up to $150 off a Ring of Security kit when you go to ring.com/comedy. Ring.com/comedy. That's ring.com/comedy.
Time to start the day. Are you both lacking in the get up and go department? Come on. You are very different people. Did you really think a traditional mattress would cut it for a dynamic duo like you? Never! Only a Sleep Number bed allows both of you to adjust your ideal firmness, comfort, and support. Your Sleep Number setting.
Plus, Sleep IQ technology tracks the quality of your sleep and tells you how to adjust your bed and your routines to sleep better. Did one of you start going to the gym again? Maybe that's the time to try a softer Sleep Number setting. Our research shows that people who use Sleep IQ technology sleep better, and it won't break your budget. In fact, J.D. Power ranks Sleep Number highest in customer satisfaction with mattresses for the second year in a row.
For more information, go to jdpower.com. Sleep IQ technology is available in all Sleep Number beds, starting under $1,100. Only at one of Sleep Number's 500 stores nationwide. For your local store, visit sleepnumber.com. No better sleep with Sleep Number. And tell them Jay and Dan from the Bonfire sent you. At Dish, they heard when you said you hated waiting for the cable guy. They know you shouldn't have to take the whole day off for nothing. Just nothing. Just twiddling your thumbs. Dish knows because they listen, so they designed a better installation process based on your needs. Dish starts by letting you pick the same day or next day installation. Then they give you a reliable 75-minute arrival window and
needs,
to keep you up to date.
Those are my wants.
Yeah. Well, you get wants and needs with Dish. All of your fantasies are fulfilled. Dish created the MyTech app with a tracker showing your installation, your installer's picture and location on a map so you'll know exactly when they arrive. No more wasting your day sitting around on the couch waiting to get your TV set up. Dish installation designed with you in mind. Featuring 75-minute arrival windows and real-time updates with the MyTech app. To learn more, call 1-844-CALL-DISH or visit dish.com. Dish, tuned into you. Call 1-844-CALL-DISH or visit dish.com. Restrictions apply. Call for more details.
Hey, hey, this is Mark Normand here, and you're listening to The Bonfire with Big J Oakerson and Dan Soda, one of the best shows out there. Call me.
Yeah. Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95, Big J Oakerson, Dan Soder, sitting in with us all day, Mark Normand.
Hey, hey.
Whose new special, Don't Be Yourself, premieres Comedy Central this Friday, March 12th.
Thank you, sir.
At midnight. Make sure you check that out, man. Mark is one of the funniest guys working in comedy. And
really is.
I'm so proud to see what he's done, like how far he's coming.
It's always great.
The special's going to be great.
Yeah. When one of the good guys gets a win, it's always the best.
And Christine went to a taping, I believe.
Yeah.
Yeah, and said it was fucking fantastic.
How do you feel about it?
I got to tell you, obviously, you do the special, you put in the can. I've already written like four tags that I wish were in there, but, that's how it goes. That's c'est la vie.
Well, make sure you guys check it out because, DVR that shit so you can keep it.
Yeah.
And then we're playing Beat Nuts all day.
Nice.
Queens.
Beat them nuts.
Yeah, beat them nuts.
Because our friend of the show, Cypher Sounds, introduced us to a camper.
Wait, the comedian?
Yeah, Cypher Sounds,
the
comedian.
God, the comedian. I know him.
Introduced us, last night I was at the cellar and I met Juju from the Beatnuts.
Wow. So cool.
He's a camper. Juju from the Beatnuts is a camper.
Yeah, it's crazy. He was super excited to meet Soder.
It was
awesome.
Fucking crazy. It was like, it was one of those things where I thought I was being fucked with.
Yeah.
When you're like, oh, no, you don't mean that. Like, you're just saying that. He's like, no, man. He's like, I fuck with you and Jay. And I was like, dude, that is crazy.
That's so cool.
That's
my
huge.
Favorite thing to do now since you told me about it is go, like, maybe once a month, I remember to try to do it, is go on actual Twitter.
Yeah.
Because I use some other app just for some reason. That's just the one I've always used.
for Twitter, but the actual Twitter app, you can go to that thing and see who follows you, who's verified.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
It's such a cool, fun thing to do, and you just go and like, you know, I follow people back. Yeah, but, right. From that.
I told you, man, when Queens of the Stone Age followed me back.
Yeah, it's
wow.
I got some injury. I have a couple UFC fighters and
but
shit.
But I think I found out why they did is because, My Netflix half hour that's coming out in July, I think they licensed the song to Netflix to use as my walkout song.
Oh, really?
If I had a tail. Because I asked Comedy Central to do it, and then Queens of the Stone Age, like the licensing people for that song were not Queens of the Stone Age, and I think this was Queens of the Stone Age. I don't know. But it's one of those feelings where it was like, you know, crazy. My favorite,
that's huge.
My favorite band of all time. And, I mean,
QOTSR?
Quatsa. And meeting Juju from the Beatnuts last night and knowing that he...
Listens
to the show and is like a fan is like, so we're going to have him and I told him and Cypher, they got to come on in June when we get back.
Nice.
Oh, hell yeah.
That'll absolutely be fucking great.
Wait, I wanted, before you say that, I want to ask, cause I think we'll, now that Mark just did his hour special, we could all relate to this question some way, but, are you worried now? Like when it comes out, are you going to try to stop doing that jokes in that hour completely or no?
Yeah, I'm gonna try, but I only have like 20 minutes.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna say. That was weird. And I was on the phone with my manager and I mentioned the same thing. I thought it was interesting. I was like, man, I'm so happy because like I feel like by winter I could be ready for an hour, another hour. And it's been that'd be 2 years.
Yeah, that's right.
Last one. And I go, that's pretty good. And I go, it's funny because when I went out a few weekends after, I remember just as far back ago as doing like Grand Rapids, Michigan, months ago that I was there. I remember being out there being like, man, I'm doing like 85% crowd stuff because I'm not a joke writer, so like I got to do that, and the jokes kind of evolve from that. To like now I think I have like 35.
That's gotta be a good feeling.
Well, and I'm not going on the road now, but that's for a while. The road was getting daunting.
Yes.
It's like, I don't want to do the jokes because now that people are coming saying they saw the special and you're like,
it's terrifying.
We're not musicians, man. They don't want to hear this. They don't want to hear the same track.
And I'm caught in a weird mishmash of that because you feel that body of work where you're like, oh shit, this is a majority new stuff. And then I was lucky that Netflix was like, hey, you want to film that? And you're
shit. So you're in back July, to zero again.
I'm back to zero again.
Yeah,
where now,
I thought about that with the half hours even. Like,
it's like, it's gone. It's all like, but that's, I think the most fun part of being a comic is, and now you're starting to see like when a little becomes a little bit more and
yes,
a little bit more
yes.
And then it's like now I got like, we filmed that March 1st, I feel like I have like 15 minutes that's new where I'm like, this is gonna be new.
It's the only down of doing a half hour at all is like you've set yourself back probably just for the actual production and processing of it like another year and a half, 2 years before you do an hour.
Oh, absolutely. I definitely, but that's almost in a weird way, it's liberating knowing I don't have to do a special till 2019.
Good for you. Yeah, right. So it's like, just explore.
But also, just having fun.
I'd like to get out one more, I'd like to get another hour in like a year.
Yeah, but that's the great time that we're living in right now with all this technology, and it's like comedy's in a fucking good place right now.
Big. It's a boom.
It's a bubble.
I'm at the Arlington Draft House this weekend, and it's going to play while I'm on stage, I guess.
That's the best.
And I'm like, great, because I can just do it one last time, you know, legitimately.
Yeah. Dude, I felt I was at Madison. I was at Comedy on State when mine aired, and I felt like I was like, it was the last time I enjoyed doing the jokes.
Yes.
Because I was like, you motherfuckers haven't even heard this.
Right.
But what's worse is, and both of you will attest to this, when you put a new bit on a special, and then you're like, I don't think it was done growing
yet. It grows so much, sure.
Of course. That's what I'm saying.
I definitely have, what sucks is like, some of the, when I even say like a new like 30 or 40 that I have now.
Yeah.
Of material, I'd say like, some of it starts, there's parts of it I would actually have to leave out because, I did that.
Uh-huh.
But I can still make the jokes like elemental enough that I can like, I can leave the part from the first special out and do it.
So, so what's great about that is that's what happened with one of my jokes in the half hour where I was like, oh, I riffed a line on my hour special that I can't use. And it was like a thing that led me to that new bit. But then what's crazy is I did a different bit, and now that I'm back on the road, I've gone back to the hour way of doing it.
Oh, no.
So it's almost like, but it feels like when the half hour comes out, they'll be like, oh, he kind of does a different version of that joke.
Okay.
You just go on and confuse them.
I don't know if we're all stoned, but you just drew like a real roadmap with like red yarn that I'm not gonna lie, at the end of it, I didn't follow it.
Well, you know what? You just gotta let go, bro.
I do it in the half hour, but now it's back.
Yeah, that was deception. That was like a comedy deception.
What if I told you there's two parallel jokes?
He goes, and then they fold into each other.
I go, you know what? You know when I reveal the punchline? 7 years from now, I release a tweet
That makes all sense.
It's called a TIG.
Yeah, a TIG.
we have an interesting call, but I want to know before I worry about that, because I think I'll get into a conversation, is what you looked very excited on the break.
Yeah, I saw a news story that just broke.
Ooh, yeah.
That we didn't even know about, and it's for a show.
Cat Williams loses to another eighth grader?
I'm all the way down in sixth grade fighting these little pimping bitches.
If I get my record back to even, I could get back into the big venue.
Here's the deal. I'm trying to cut weight, get down to fifth graders, and try to win.
Dr. Phil's representatives confirm he was involved in a dirt bike accident. But
dirt bikes?
Dude, it gets better.
I'll do motocross.
Oh, you guys want to see me do a backflip on a bike? It's fucking rad. I'll rip it. Check this out. Dr. Phil knows how to keep a secret. The TV personality kept a serious dirt bike accident from his fans for months. This is my favorite. In late February, during some time off, Dr. Phil, practicing a dirt bike trick with some of his Hollywood stuntman friends, landed awkwardly and dislocated his shoulder and dinged up a few ribs.
That's a weird way to put it. Dinged up your ribs?
Yeah.
I love that he gets up and he goes, I need you to knock it back into place. Go, what do you mean? He goes,
fucking Mel Gibson?
Yeah, he goes, I gotta slam it into that file cabinet. I was doing a kick-ass Superman jump where I let go of the back and then I bring it back under me. I'm going for the X game.
You were practicing stunts? With a stuntman, and you're not a stuntman doing the same stunts? Why would you do that?
Yeah. Turns out I did a sweet sidekick, nice heel kick, into a Superman, and I blew it.
What do you mean if it was like, this is Dr. Phil, and then you see when he goes to the ring, does a thing where he gets off the bike completely and, like, lays sideways and comes back onto it?
He's a Superman?
Yeah. Let's the bike go and pulls it back with his feet.
Yeah.
You want to know where I learned that? With balanced psychology.
By the way, dirt bike accident sounds like a term for, like, sloppy anal.
Yeah.
Had a real dirt bike accident last night. Yeah. I was covered.
I thought she was dead.
That's fucking. I really, when you said dirt bike accident, I thought it was going to mean like he wandered onto a track and a dirt bike hit him or something. I wouldn't picture he was over there and goes, oh, what are we going to do? Rip up the course?
Yeah. Oh, you guys want me to go? I'm going to take the governor off and let this puppy fly.
The governor.
He goes, yeah, this thing's about 40. I could probably kick this over. Why don't you go lay down? I'm going to do a backflip over you. I just love him busting his shoulder. Get it in. Pop it back in. No, Mickey, grab my wrist. Move it in.
His stuntman friends. Yeah. Why is Dr. Phil just friends with stuntman friends? I'm doing Saturday with my stuntman friend.
Yeah. Hey, if you wouldn't mind watching Maggie, I got to go rip it. We're going to go swimming. Basically, my life is like Point Break. I just go do extreme stuff. I rob banks just to come. All right. Now I want to get to the video that you want to talk about. Because
this is pretty good.
I'm very excited to watch this. And Norman's a perfect person to have on the show.
Oh, boy. Is it porn?
This is pretty. I'm almost wondering if we should preemptively take our second break here.
Yeah.
Because when we come back, we'll talk. This is a 9-minute video that we're going to skim through. But I think this will take us right to Mark having
Well, can I just say, it's great to be on the show because I've been, you know, Pam, the publicist, has been running me ragged all day. And I got chewed out at the Good Morning Football.
Why?
I made a, you know, it's in the morning, so you got to be super squeaky clean. And she was like, just, you know, be clean. I'm in the waiting in the wing. She's like, don't say anything crazy, you know, blah, blah, blah. And I was like, I'll be fine. And I used to be my high school mascot, so we were talking about that because I don't know much about sports. And the lady on the show was like, do some moves, which I hate when they do that. You know, like, sing a few, try to get laughs, you know. So I was like, I can't do it. I'll turn you on. You might fall off your chair. You might slip. And she fucking lost it.
On air?
No, but she wouldn't talk to me anymore. Like, the other guys had to, like, be like chime in, like, oh, hey, so Mark, how's Dr. Phil's dirt bike? You know, like, they had to change the subject real quick. But I didn't think that was that bad. When it's I got off, they were bad, yelling at me, and I was like, I didn't even know what I did.
What did you do?
It's not that big
what
deal.
Did you do?
You flip off the chair.
She was personally offended.
She was pissed.
What a weird thing to be pissed off.
I know.
I mean, if you're like the girl who's like, I'm a guy's girl who talks about sports.
They're full of shit.
And a wet puss joke gets you upset.
She goes, I was offended. Also, these grown men giving each other professional brain damage.
Right.
That doesn't bother me.
She's like, that does get my box slippery.
You know what I love watching is a guy that weighs 300 pounds runs a 4.8 40 just truck right into our right guard who's pulling for a downhill toss. And then I'm like, you're like, does your pussy get wet? You fucking creep.
You know what flips my cookie? A big guy hitting a chick in an elevator.
Yeah.
You know? But don't talk about my moisture.
Yeah. She's like, you know what I like? After the game, I go in the locker room, and all those guys' dicks just cross you over each other, and I run through them like football practice.
Like car wash.
Or what I'll do is I'll just suck off a D lineman, and then I'll go shoot it on my chest like I have a brain injury, and I'm trying to preserve my brain for science.
Hey, that's hurting you on your pussy I went, huh?
Oh, get out of here!
You're evil!
Exactly!
Fuck that. Welcome to the bonfire, Mark.
Thanks, good to be back.
You're safe here.
Yes, a safe space.
This is indeed a safe space. So we'll take our break here, and we'll come back with this video.
Yeah, I'm really excited.
We'll be right back. Mark Norman again, a special premiering this Friday at midnight. Christine, please. His new hour special, Don't Be Yourself, premiering Comedy Central this Friday at midnight. Mark Norman's hanging out with us for the next segment, at least.
Yeah.
We'll be right back. It's The Bonfire. Hey, it's Joe DeRosa. You're listening to The Big Old Bonfire with my pals Big J. Oakerson and Dickie Dan Soder. Have fun, fuckos.
The Beat Nuts on The Bonfire all day long. Why? Because I found out that Juju of The Beat Nuts is a camper, and we're celebrating by playing their awesome songs.
Major, major camper.
Major camper. Welcome to The Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J. Oakerson. And in studio, the Mark Norman.
Yo.
Whose new hour special, Don't Be Yourself, premiering this Friday, May 12th on Comedy Central at midnight. You could also hear him hosting The Drive Home earlier that day, 5:30 Eastern, 5 p.m. on the West Coast with guest Greg Stone.
Hey.
Very high on our show Monday. No sense in one riff to the point that it almost upset Jay.
He's a mess.
Jay goes, I don't know what that even means.
It was just words. He just said a bunch of words.
Yeah. Speaking of words, some words make women go crazy, Jay, right?
Ooh, slip off the chair.
Mm. Some words. Oh, but while we're doing our plugs, let's get our plugs.
Well, yo, my man. Here it comes. He's going to be, that's right, the ladies love Jay Oakerson. They're going to be at Sacramento Punchline this weekend, Thursday through Saturday, May 11th through May 13th, with the homeboy Dave Smith.
Davey Smith going to be working with me out there.
From Legion of Skanks. So go get tickets at bigjcomedy.com, Sacramento.
And, of course, Dan Soder. Dan's going to be at the old Laugh It Up Comedy Club in Poughkeepsie, New York. One night only. What night is that, you're probably asking? Well, it's Saturday, May 27th. And you can get your tickets immediately at the all-new and new refurbished DanSoder.com.
Ooh.
The tickets will go fast because...
Murkface, we're going to miss you. Murkface, Andy, leaving
45
us.
45 more minutes of Murkface.
45. Yeah. So, Murkface... Should we get to the video first, or should we say goodbye to Murkface?
No, we're going to give...
Should we give Murkface his present first?
Oh,
no.
Come on.
This is a whole... It's a ceremony.
Okay.
We do that at the very end.
Murkface will be joining Nick DiPaolo's show.
Ooh, step down.
Come on.
Good, then get the hell out of my life. Who needs you? Beat it. Leave me alone.
I love Nick DiPaolo, so I think you're going to a good home, but I'm upset that Sirius is forcing you away from us.
Yeah,
Should we, before Mark leaves, before we look at this video, should we present him with
Jacob's thing? Yes. Why don't we present him with Jacob's thing? Murkface, shut your eyes.
Is there a gift?
Why'd you do that?
Aww. What we did is we got your ex-girlfriend.
I'll be honest, Murkface. Whatever's going through your head right now, like you guys shouldn't have, I promise you we didn't.
Yeah.
All right.
Trust me.
I should have.
Minimal effort went into you leaving us.
It's exciting. I just saw it.
Because now I feel bad. I'm like, should we get him a laptop or something?
No. Why the fuck are we get him a laptop?
I need a new one.
Oh, my God. I love it.
I don't know whether to believe Mark or not.
That's a big swastika.
All right, Murkface. Open your eyes.
Aw. Yeah.
You get
perfect.
So you get a patented Bonfire Big Cookie. Thanks. Whenever we have a celebration on the show, it's a big cookie, and this one no different. On the cookie, Jacob had it written by Trader.
By Trader. Now
that's Jay's line, by the way. Full credit, writing credit goes to
everyone.
Mercadick Arnold.
Hey guys, quick question here. I know we don't only people use the studio here, but is that a fucking thing of hot sauce just in the studio?
Yeah, it's been there for a while, actually.
Why?
And there was a black show in here before.
I bet there was. I know there was.
Well, follow
delicious.
Us.
Thank you.
By the way, now everyone knows why I was trying to get milk earlier.
Oh, dude, we need some milk.
At the Bonfire SXM on Twitter and Instagram, Snapchat, and Facebook, you can see us, the cookie we just gave Merkface, because he's leaving us for the Nick DiPaolo show next week.
I hate
eating it with his hands. It's mine.
It's my cookie.
Save me a bite, will you?
I'm a cookie monster.
I think we'll be all right.
All right. That looks amazing.
We will never... ever see Andy ever again.
That's not true. I'd be right across the hall.
I'll tell you, which studio are you going to be in?
11.
Competing with us.
Ouch.
Directly.
Ron Bennington's.
Damn.
That we'll see each other all the time.
Wait, so you're in Ron Bennington's thing, but Nick's not here.
He's here.
He's going to be coming in to do it.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you're going to change. You're going to be talking about how we should build a wall. You're going to be different.
I get a lot more racist.
Oh, yeah, it's going to spark you up.
Oh,
yeah.
Dude, I can't wait to see your haircut when you go over there.
Oh, yeah, he's going to call you a hippie.
Now you're all long and shaggy.
You're going to embrace the Fiore in me. Oh. Real Italian.
There you go.
Well, maybe the official last video we'll ever watch together as a family. I guess it would be really delicious if we had some fucking milk. Anybody? No, Jacob, you
don't.
It'd
be nice.
The funny thing is, we should make Andy as his last act go get his fucking milk.
They have some at the fucking
kiosk.
Yeah, right. Or is it all just?
No, they should have some in the kitchen.
Oh, in the kitchen, there's got
to
be a full.
There has to be. There's. Listen, I mean, the way the kitchen used to be, it was half gallons all over.
Ooh. That was back in the salad days.
Goodbye to yesterday. I'm eating this without milk like a jerk off.
I know you go for the corner there or the outer edges there, Jay.
Easiest grab.
Oh, okay.
Without finger fucking the whole thing.
I know, because I want a middle, but I'm
going middle, but it's so hard. It's so hard to get a middle.
It's hard to get just middle.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
The video I want to show you, Dan, is there. Did you find this, Christine?
It's a great cookie. Yeah.
There's a girl who I find attractive in some weird way. It looks like her body's actually great in moments when you see her. But
where'd you find her? Is this on WorldStar you found this?
No. This was actually in Pornhub.
Ooh. Oh, nice.
But there's nothing dirty about this, at least what I got to. It's 9 minutes long.
It's funny how well I know all these ads.
But it's me too. I really do. And I'll be honest with you, I don't think anyone can make my dick grow 2 to 4. I don't think it's possible.
No. That kid's like, real confident.
Yeah. I was like the yoga where it goes crazy.
I know.
I love yoga. Rip your pants.
Yeah. Everybody knows
pants,
that. Yeah. Every guy knows that one. And they start banging real quick, and then he squirts on her, and then fucking back to that.
And Ron Jeremy, if I click this, Ron Jeremy's prepared to give me his secret for a bigger dick.
Right.
But I don't think it's going to happen.
The yoga one's weird because they're mad at him, and they fuck him out of punishment.
Yeah, what a weird, cool punishment.
I know, his dick's hanging out, and they're like, this pig, and then they fuck him.
Let's show him who's boss.
Yeah.
You ever see a girl on the ad that's so high, you try to find that clip, but it doesn't exist?
It's a ghost. That's a ghost clip.
Oh, interesting.
You know what I've recently done?
Killed a man. The late night. Just for an erection.
To watch a soul escape?
The late night ads on TV for the 800 numbers?
Yeah.
I've tracked those girls down on the internet.
That's too scary.
Yeah.
That's too scary.
Yeah.
That's too much, Andy. I'm glad you're leaving.
Did you not say track them down? That does sound creepy.
He goes like this. He goes, so I'm outside her house, breathing through my nose heavy.
And I let me finish. On the internet was the end of that sentence.
And then she's walking out of her house, and he has his cell phone over his head. He goes, guess who I'm calling? You.
How do you do it? What, are you just typing hotline?
It shows their names.
The call is coming from inside the house.
Mr. Norman, the call seems to be coming from inside your house.
And he's like, I don't want to chat anymore. She's like,
too bad I can't see you, baby.
He goes, you can't see me, but I can see you.
So I'll tell you, this girl I find to be sort of pretty.
Right.
She gets not pretty during it.
Can I tell you right now, her wizard shirt is amazing.
I said to you early this chick is garbage.
Whoa.
She's got a barn door, too.
No, this chick is absolute garbage, but
She's, I actually like that door behind her.
Yeah,
I think that's good closeting.
$50 at Target.
No shit.
I got one.
With the act, were you hanging on the wall?
Yeah, it's real easy.
So you don't have to do those stupid every apartment closet that's never on the fucking.
It's
exactly.
At mine, I just wail it back in, and it always just comes right back out. Anyway, this is another conversation for that time. This is about this garbage chick who's super into Harry Styles from One Direction, and the reaction she has. I love music. So do you? I'm a big music lover.
Is she like? Is she into Harry Styles? Is like that crowd is into Carlos?
Way more. She has a physical reaction to just hearing him sing. She's debuting for herself his new solo album. Harry Styles is from One Direction.
Yeah, yeah. And, hot guy. Girls like him.
Girls love him. Mm. And he, this girl's way in and just, she seems almost semi-rational.
Okay. Mm.
And in the first like 30, 40 seconds, and then it just, she just like delves into this really bizarre, obsessive behavior over a song. And I'm telling you, she does gross stuff.
He looks like a pretty lady.
Yeah, the
looks like that
love
face
him.
App where you, don't, like, you put him as a chick.
Yeah, like a hot Jagger girl.
Oh, yeah. Look at that.
Yeah, he's a gorgeous kid.
Gorgeous, gorgeous man.
I went to SNL when Fallon hosted and he was the guest.
Yeah.
Me and Che went to the after party and it was just like a trail of slippery floor behind him.
Yeah, it was like one of those fucking foam parties.
Yeah,
where it's all wet soap on the floor. Yeah,
but he also strikes me as a guy who wears like a he has like a promise ring to his mom or something.
Right, he's emotional.
My mom gave me a little bit of a necklace before I left her to the arenas.
That's not Harry Styles' voice at all.
Keep a bit of me purity. My mommy said if I was going to leave the island, I had to be a good boy.
All your Brits are just Ringo.
Yeah. And I'm like, okay. Let me carry the beat, Paul.
Well, I'm going to make a solo album, I'm going to.
I know I'm in One Direction, but I want to be a solo artist. I want to be a solo artist.
It's great if you give him that voice, if you give him Ray Winstone's voice, where he's like, oh, I'm a little bit upset being in One Direction. I don't like it. There's guys you can hit, and there's guys you can't hit.
Yeah,
I'm not saying he's one of them. But now I'm calling it.
Me solo work
focuses on love.
So this girl, I want you to watch this girl's emotional.
But it's porn.
It's a, nope.
Wait,
I don't know
minute.
Why. It's just that crazy of a video that they'll put them on these sites.
Whoa, they're doing that now?
You know what? In fairness, maybe it delves into she gets naked. I don't know. I watched 3 minutes of the 9 minutes of it.
We have to finish it, or at least fast forward.
Oh, yeah, we'll skim through. But I just want you to see. I've never felt this emotional about new music, ever.
I mean, I might feel this way about the new Queens of the Stone Age 25 when it comes out.
They should really follow you double because you've said their name 73 times in the show today.
QueensOfStoneAge.com for all merchandise and tour dates. Quasa.com. Q-O-T-C-A.
Play it. I'm going back in for more cookie.
Throw me a piece.
Oh, she's cute.
And she's Denver cute.
Shut your fucking mouth. Because that's absolutely what she is. That's 100% what she is.
She blew God, spider.
God damn you, Mark Norman. You just nailed it. She's Aurora Hot.
The Aurora Hot.
Yeah.
And I was just in Denver, so I know.
Ah, she's totally Aurora Hot.
I got you some
AKA
middle.
The day that Harry rises from the dead.
What?
I look like absolute trash.
Yeah. Oh, she's got a hemp choker. Great Scott.
And, I'm about to listen to Harry Styles' Sign of the Times for the first time.
For the first time?
And,
not the last.
She is Aurora Hot. Yeah. Now I agree.
Harry Styles has always been my bitch. When One Direction was still a thing, all the boys were ghosts to me, and I love the boys.
Oh my God.
But like all of my attention, it was just on him.
Oh God, there's going to be some poor asshole that sits through this for a blowjob.
Like, I wanted to.
Where he goes, yeah, no, the rest of them were ghosts.
But
everyone in her neighborhood is sitting through it for a blowjob.
Yeah, her stepdad even.
From the dead, he is sprouting into the beautiful sunflower that he is. I've never been more ready in my life.
She is 1,000% Aurora Garden.
Yep, we're about to do this shit.
Oh my God. She sounds like
I'm about to lose my clit.
What?
Oh my God, I'm not.
She's about to lose her clit.
This, dude.
You guys heard her.
That's a piano.
Now she just starts.
Is she jerking it?
No, she just gets wildly emotional.
But she's making the clit rubbing faces.
Oh, it gets there.
Oh, okay. It's a sign of the times. You look pretty good down here. Jesus. But you ain't really
good. Oh my god, his voice.
Oh my god, his voice. It's me going,
Dan, get in here.
Yes, she goes, Dan. I'm like, I'm playing Madden. What do you want?
Dan, didn't you have the voice of an angel?
He sounds like an angel, dude.
What did this do to your boner, Jay? Were you just confused? Your dick probably looked
like, jerking it. I wasn't jerking it. I was going through the weird videos of the day.
Oh, all right. You're just getting everything from Pornhub now. News and videos.
Yeah. Oh, what?
Drools. Drooling? Oh, yeah, Merc Face, you're in.
Yeah. She's a spitter. Oh, she's twerking. Hello?
But she's like twerking like she's like... She has to get rid of something.
Right. Yeah,
like it's a dance.
Decent ass, though.
I'm so, she's under the radar.
This part, dude. This part
right here. I swear to God, it's me as a chick. Aw, dude. I'm a double guns because my pussy's sopping right now.
We're going to put this at the Bonfire SXM on Twitter.
Her sister left because she's fucking going full. She's grabbing her pussy over her pants.
She's wearing a fucking, like, Jersey Turnpike t-shirt.
Dude, that is such an airport truck stop.
Yeah.
Why does she keep... How many times did she listen to
it? She's like, I got this in the front.
The engine as well.
Her stepdad walks down the stairs. He goes, Michelle, are you going to keep yelling like that?
Take your medicine.
Her sister's putting her hand out like,
hey, give me your hand.
Is that her mom?
I assume it's her sister maybe, but she's like, really, like, do you need help?
Maybe.
She's exorcist walking.
Oh, weird. Oh, and she ate shit. Is this girl on drugs?
She's on salvia or whatever. I don't know if you
take drugs and listen to Harry Styles.
That's what a lame asshole does.
People do it.
She's the best.
She's great.
This is what I picture Christine used to do with my first album before we met.
Because the story is so complete.
Oh, my God. He is an American storyteller. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, I'm twerking it out. I'm twerking it out.
Oh, God. Oh, Puerto Rican in Alaska. Oh, God.
Accurate as fuck. Can't you imagine that song? It was like the girlfriend's driving away.
What?
Like the montage starts. Totally. And she's like leaving her lover from back home.
Right? Like super sad.
I hate like both
moving
of
to a new Jesus. City.
She is a problem.
She's like, she has
this like the scene. This is like what happened like in the same scene. Pause
Holy
it for a second.
Fuck that song.
This is like the scene in, it's like Christine always hates that scene in Boogie Nights, right?
Yeah.
When Heather Graham and Joanne
Margulies. Blow?
Like, you want to stay in this room forever? We didn't just lock ourselves in here and never leave this room.
Can I ask you a question? Will you be my mom?
Just, I'll ask you if you're my mom and then you say yes, okay?
You say yes.
Okay, are you my mom?
Yeah.
Oh my god, I never want to leave this room.
I'm not going to be there.
I just want to say Harry Styles.
Harry Styles.
Oh man.
Oh.
Keep it going.
He's never been so relevant.
What?
Ah,
you guys.
You know, she looks like an agent talking
my
to Gerard
wig.
Carmichael.
Yeah.
That's all I got to say.
That's a little insane.
I'm so proud of Harry.
Well, he'll never hear.
He deserves this.
He might.
If I have anything to say about it, he'll find out.
Yeah.
Without
he could be
any
watching
contracts
porn.
Holding him back.
What?
Without anyone holding him back, this is who he is now. This is like his real self. This is his sound. It sounds like a fucking 70s rock song.
No, it didn't.
No,
I don't know
all.
What I'm going to do when a full length album comes out.
Now you're gonna shit your pants.
That's causing me stress. And that song.
First off, the name of the video is Harry Styles Makes Brunette Bitch Bust.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, where's the busting?
That's the greatest.
That song is going on repeat until my lungs give out. Hey guys, I switched locations because
my lungs went out. My lungs went out in that room.
Turned out.
Do not make deals with God like that.
He collapsed my left one.
I don't think I'm in the position to really talk to anyone today. No
one talked
to me. Unless you're playing this tune.
That's so funny. Her.
She's cute enough.
She is cuter than
all of my expectations.
I thought.
She calls out of work because of Harry Styles. She's like, can you pick up my shift? I have to listen to the Harry Styles record.
She's like, Harry Styles brought back my endometriosis.
The echoes... That just proved that he's an actual angel. So,
good luck.
And he's actually speaking about some real shit. Is he talking about the end of the world?
Now, if you're in whatever, pause it. Now, if you're in whatever bumfuck town she's in, and you want this girl to blow you, how much would you before you had to snap back and be, sweetie, I'm sorry, I'd love to fuck, but like, I can't listen anymore about Harry Styles. I can't.
Yeah.
She goes, he's literally an angel.
And one time, she goes, do you understand? He goes, I have a picture I took of him, and you could see there's like a sunburst kind of behind him, like, and it was like, nighttime, but it was like nighttime, and, there's, and you're like, I don't want to. Please don't make me.
I feel bad. I'd be like, yeah, I see it. It looks good. I feel the whole way.
I feel the whole way. He's, oh my God, you know what's funny? He goes, I think he might be an angel, but I believe in him. I'm a guy who believes in angels.
Ah, that's so. You know what's so weird? I remember the first time I saw One Direction, I go, who are those ghosts and that angel?
Yes.
She goes, I was thinking the same thing.
So it's weird that we both put it together and we both said ghost things. Do you think that means like somewhere in this crazy cosmic path? I hate to get all your t-shirt about this, but that we're on this crazy cosmic path.
You go, maybe, were supposed to meet.
You know, maybe, yeah, I'm just going to throw this out there. Maybe you could blow me and I'll like pretend I'm Harry.
I bet our sexual chemistry is
oh my Christ. Do you have a reverse crab walk?
Can you blow me? I'll do my Harry Styles for you. Oh, that's good. You're using it to be around the rim, dude.
Yeah, you're drinking that long. It's a glass of mead.
I could use a couple of your fingers in me arse if you wouldn't mind.
You like me long hair, do you? Hello, is this the brunette who I made bust?
Oh, hey, Bird.
Hey, Bird, I'm on a tour bus outside of Manchester right now.
Oh, yeah, my hand.
How about you get that sloppy taco on? Goldstream. I'll meet you in Minneapolis and we'll fuck in the hotel. Don't make eye contact.
Maybe you
later.
Maybe you could spitball some video ideas with me.
Yeah. I'm thinking about taking this whole angel concept to another level.
You guys are doing all the Captain Hook's henchmen.
She's describing with her sister.
Yeah.
Rubio.
I like that idea that you and the other hog was kicking around about a girlfriend leaving a boyfriend, yeah?
I got a lot of girlfriends, but with you, I want to go solo.
Get it? Like four directions. I got one direction. Right in your stinker.
Let's see it. Let's see the rest.
Everything is corrupt in this world. Uh-huh. It's like the sign of...
Wait, pause it. Jay, just do the I want to fuck you uh-huhs for okay, everything yeah. she said.
Back it up like 30 seconds.
So just hype man her.
I'll do the next 3 minutes with it.
Like you're trying to fuck her.
Turn it up, baby. Can't hear you.
The echoes. That just proved that he's an actual angel.
Yeah, I mean,
so,
like... Yeah.
And he's actually speaking about some real shit.
Well, that's what you want your music to do. I mean, you know...
Is he talking about how everything is corrupt in this world? And it's like the sign of, like, this world's about to end?
It is about to end. It's a creepy... You know, he's a deep guy.
He couldn't express those thoughts in One Direction.
No.
All One Direction.
Well, it's a boy band. I mean, the show's his talent, but I mean...
Yeah.
Bless you, sweetheart. Bless you. I'm sorry.
She's sick.
You didn't cover him. I didn't cover my mouth. That's okay. That's good.
They're such sweet guys. We have a chance.
Now you're at the real flock of fags. I get it. Harry was the only real man.
See, I'd play off the angle of like, you know, I've never heard him. And she'd be like, oh my God, I get to be the first person to show you Harry.
Oh God, I can't wait to watch your face the first time you hear Harry.
Oh, that's some real acting you gotta do there.
No, I mean, I started doing, cause I don't look like I would, like she would believe that, so I have to go. It's like, well, you know, it's really the thing is, I'm into all kinds of, a lot of people know I'm into all kinds of music,
right.
So it's like, you know, I got everything in my thing, and Harry Styles is like a pretty talented guy.
Can make a
time,
point.
You
can
and
make
I'm
point.
Ready to take on my day.
Lit.
You know, it's raining outside.
And B,
you know,
this
you
is at home.
Really
she's
sad during this type of
pajamas. Thing. I bet she dolls herself up real nice.
I think you're right. Surviving.
Hold on, back that up. She just said she's thriving and surviving after this record. So, Andy, I don't care how dolled up she gets. She's a dum-dum.
I love her.
I'm thriving.
She's got a rug on her wall.
Has been snatched. I am bald for a few days.
What?
Bald for a few months.
She talks like she runs a Ron John's surf shop. She goes, I'm out there. It's a rip curl. I know what's going on. And I go, I'm either going to eat sand or eat like a legend. And, bro, when I want to eat like a legend, I get two spoonfuls. So I grab my board. It's waxed up. And I'm just, like, riding that tube. And I'm like,
tasty wave.
And I can just feel Harry in my head. Like, baby girl, get through this tube. And we're going to be together forever.
This is the sign of the times.
Then he wrote that song. I didn't think none of that.
And you're like, oh, I want to think about that.
I woke up and I was like, how do I make more money and how do I fuck more sneeze?
play the video.
Is it an ending? Is there like a money shot?
You know, it's raining outside. You know, usually I'd be really sad during this type of weather.
All right, well, you're weak.
But I'm thriving. I'm surviving. And
I'm dry?
I'm
ready to start driving.
I'm going to be watching his 2-hour-long interview. Not ready for that shit. My anxiety is gone. I'm ready to take on the world.
Oh, my
Fuck
God.
Yeah. Harry motherfucking Styles. You didn't see it coming. He just popped out of nowhere like a little flower in the spring.
He popped out of
and
the
that's
X
exactly
Factor.
What he's sprouting, y'all.
Sprouting, y'all.
And he's being himself. He's letting his freak flag fly.
Love, I've been freaking my freak flag since I was in that devil's threesome when I was 9 years old.
70s vibes that he's nourishing me with.
Nourishing?
And
dude,
I'm
this,
for
she needs to date Mike Fenoya. Stat.
Oh, dude.
You know, amigo, that's sort of how I approach comedy. That's pretty good, because I'll tell you something, friend. That's my outlook on comedy.
She just goes, and it's really tasty and crunchy.
He's like, yeah, awesome. That's what it is. It's like, you know, you know where it starts and you just accept the ride.
Fenoya's trying to bang this girl.
It's like, you know what? It's like you just commit yourself to, I'm going to hear some tunes, and you take them in, and then you let them take you on the journey, right?
You go, now, if you feel that way about Harry Styles, imagine how you feel about Trey Anastasia.
Crunchy tunes.
Oh, well, I like to think of Harry Styles as basically like a nice introduction to Fish.
Yeah.
two-hour interviews, 3-hour songs.
Yo, 2-hour interviews. How about a 4-hour jam?
Jammer view.
And he goes, that'll really brighten up a rainy day.
Oh, Styles does jam reviews. That's I like that, too.
And then he's like, by the way, open for the Jokers.
Yeah. Oh. Jammity.
All right.
Let's finish this out. Less than a minute.
I'm so happy. I love this motherfucker so much.
But is that a tapestry? Or is she laying on the floor?
That's on the wall.
Yes.
It's trippy, man.
You bets believe.
Okay.
I will be in the front row at his concert, shaking my entire ass.
Yeah. Well, that's terrifying.
In his face.
She's
not
got a solid
face.
Anal.
That's disrespectful. I'm going to be twerking.
What?
I'm going to be jerking.
Yeah.
That's so 7th grade. You know what? I'm going to be jerking.
7th grade?
I'm going to be that bitch in the front row jerking.
What?
I'm going to be doing the jerk.
She's just flipping her rein.
Harry,
look there.
That's how up his ass I am. Doing dance moves from years ago. Because I'm so happy for him.
That'll get him.
Wow. I've never lived in a world where a dance move went out of date.
He deserves nothing but this. All right. Peace and blessings, y'all. Peace I'm about to watch this interview and die.
Peace and carrots.
See ya.
All right, later. I'm going to go off myself to this interview.
Anywho.
All right, anywho's it. I'm going to
go. Down the hatch with some bleach, huh?
Yeah. I'm going to go take these pain pills and watch his interview and go into a sweet permanent sleep.
I thought you would enjoy that. That was fantastic.
Exciting.
Dude, I love that, and I love new Cockney Harry Styles.
And the longest video I've watched on a porn site.
Yeah,
without my dick out.
You know what? It's not the longest I've watched, but it's the most of one I've ever watched.
Yeah, and listen.
I always on Pornhub and learned that you got a little thing for me. You want to be in the front row jerking.
If you were Harry, wouldn't you want, like, if you were friends with him, I would have to show him that.
Yes, 1,000%.
Oh.
And you watch it like this. What the fuck?
Or
but then Harry's like,
no,
a little
you'd be
creeped
like,
out.
You'd be like, dude, can you call her and tell her if she fucks me, she can get to meet you or something?
Yeah.
That's, I would try to angle it probably.
I would love nothing more than a big Jay Oakerson, Harry Styles friendship.
Spill over.
You got to do
I get Harry Styles spillover puss. That's great.
That's a lot.
Well,
I don't even know if you can handle it.
You got juju. Yeah. You never know.
Yeah, make a headband out of that girl's dumb shirt.
She goes, hey.
I keep trophies.
Yeah.
Mark Norman's new hour special, Don't Be Yourself, premiering Comedy Central this Friday, March 12th at midnight. It's going to be fantastic. Mark, thanks for hanging with us, buddy.
Thanks for having me. Thanks for the goddamn
you got
cookie
more,
cake.
More
cookie
shit you got to do. And thanks for being here again. Don't be yourself. Comedy Central Friday, this Friday at midnight. That's Friday into Saturday, right? That's how it works.
You
I know
got
it's
it.
A big thing. And we'll be right back. Take this bitch home.
Thanks
it's
for
the bonfire.
Best show.
Hi, this is Bert Kreischer, and you're listening to the only show that exists that I would want to be third mic on. It is the greatest show on Sirius XM, and it is the blueprint for the way I want to run my career. The Bonfire with Big J Oakerson and Dan Soder.
The last ever rejoin. Merc Face will ever be a part of.
No.
I hate this.
No.
I don't like this at all. It's the Bonfire. Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. Big Jokers and Dan Soder.
No.
Jacob, Christine, Lou, and the late Merc Face.
Aw.
Merc Face.
Yeah, but
leaving the show. You've been here since day one. We've grown. We've bonded. We've played music together on stage.
That's true.
It's been such a roller coaster.
I know.
And now your fancy tastes made you take a job for more money?
Are you feeling emotional at all?
Yeah, I'm very sad. You know, I love you guys. I love everybody in this room.
Why is the dad from Teen Wolf next door?
Not.
I think we should have a conversation. I think a conversation's long overdue.
That was pure visual. I'm sorry. That's for people in the studio. Merc Face, you piece of shit. I'm going to miss you.
Do we go around the room? Do we say a few nice words?
No.
I want to hear emotional Lou.
Lou, what will you miss most about seeing Andy every day except for the 2 hours you do the show?
I sit next to him in the office, so I'm not really going to miss him.
All right. Christine.
But you guys play music together on this show. I mean, you guys
but let
are...
me say this. Andy's been here because he loves it here. His skills are way better than just answering the phone. He fucking loves it every day and has the most fun on this show, which is why I can't believe he's fucking leaving. But I will miss you, Andy. I love you.
Thanks, man. Oh. Christine?
I will miss you. I don't think any of us think you just answer the phones here, and we wish that it could have worked out for you to stay. But we, you know, we all wish you the best and want you to move forward in your own career. So this is a very exciting move for you. Although we're going to be super bummed to not have you here.
Yeah. Jacob?
Suck my dick, Andy. You're a fucking leech. I do all the goddamn heavy lifting.
Pasty, veiny faggot.
If you fucking, I swear to God, I'd catch you outside. Like, for real, not the Danielle Brugelli way. Like, in a real way. I'll fucking cut you up like a bad suit being tailored.
I will fucking end you where you stand.
I am your god.
Yeah, I'm gonna miss Andy. He's got a on the show. He's a great producer, though. So Nick is really benefiting from this. He really loves the Bonfire. So I know this hurts him, and so I'm glad we still sit next to each other. I'm gonna see him every day, and we share the same phone charger together, and that's gonna continue. But you're gonna be around.
Yeah.
You're always part of the Bonfire.
And you're still going to see Corey Feldman.
And we're still going to see Corey.
I remember.
No. I think this has to, for me, this has to be a clean break.
Yeah, and I think Jay's right. Because I remember when I met a young Andy Fiore, and he said, I'm going to be the producer on your show. And I said, buddy, I don't think you're ready for what we're about to do. And he was. He said, I took lives overseas, bro. This ain't nothing to me. This is jump rope. And he proved that it was. He's been the backbone. There's been tough times, like when I found out he was a jam band fan. Yeah, that's hard. It's hard to turn and put your back to a man who you know likes vacuum cleaners being played with his music. But you know what? I found a little bit of trust. And I found a friend. Jay, go ahead, take it from here, bud.
Andy, I've known you actually... How long have you been doing comedy for now?
8 years.
8 years stand-up comedy. I remember the first time I heard your name, it was our 15th show of Bonfire. You made no impression on me in the stand-up world. You've left no impression on me here. You will be like dust in the wind.
You, sir.
And some other sap will be in here eating our shit. While we fucking answer.
You are like plastic furniture on a carpet. Easily forgettable.
Andy, you are a million times more than a phone screen on the show, buddy. I'm going to miss you absolutely very dearly, and I love you, buddy, and I'm glad that we became friends through this show, and that will continue to be the case.
Yeah.
Thanks, everybody. I love you, too.
But you're off the barbecue list.
But that's if DePaulo does get fired,
or he fires you.
You'll always have a home on a different show at Sirius.
At golf, you can maybe hopefully get hired by the golf people, and then on Mondays you can look through a window at us.
You're like, oh man, I can almost smell the fun through the window.
Ben's like, hey, Andy, could you go get me another glass of orange juice? Sorry,
but he goes, hey man, go grab me a glass of juice. What kind of juice you want there, Ben? He just looks at you like, what?
He takes
sorry, that's a stupid question.
Oh, sorry, bro. Sorry. You want to talk Rangers? He goes, no, because they don't have orange in their uniforms. You bring up the Bengals. You bring up.
You are going to be the executive producer for the new Nick DiPaolo show, yep. Called simply the Nick DiPaolo show.
That's it.
On Faction Radio, 6 to 8.
Yeah.
That is the last time we'll ever promote that.
Yeah, that is. Yeah. I am a massive Nick DiPaolo fan. That is the only time we'll.
From 6 to 8 Eastern. However, available also, I believe, on demand.
Yes, check out the on demand app with Sirius to hear Andy at his new job, because you'll be listening to us, right?
Please listen to both.
Please listen to both.
Absolutely. But and we do actually have a gift.
Yeah, we do.
For Andy.
Are we getting on this?
I mean, no. That's got to be in the office. He'll see it every day.
That's so great.
Yeah, someone sent it. Who sent that? Do we have a thing?
Do you have a note with who sent
it's
this?
It's right behind you there.
It's on top of it. I circled the guy.
Thought you guys could use this for inspiration. It comes from Clayton. Clayton sent us a Gran Torino print. It's a framed art print from Raphael Asayo.
Oh, yeah, Clayton Gore. Good man.
Goddamn Andy going over to one of them Italian shows. Yeah. Going to one of those goddamn noodle slippers. Have fun over at your new radio show with one of them goddamn eggplant suckers. What's next, huh? You have one of those Mussolini faggots telling you what to do on the air?
I run around with your goddamn mom and her fucking manicotti making hands.
Yeah, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, I know English. I hope you get blown up like Apollonia.
Nothing like some Guido sweating garlic through in the public pool.
Oh, yeah, you got that Dago grease on the top like a goddamn, like some skin on a gravy.
I bet he's uncomfortably close to his sister, who's fat and has huge titties.
Yeah, you want to see a gorilla meet an Italian grandmother.
So thank you very much for that, Clayton. But then we have an actual...
Let's do a ceremony here.
Ceremony time, Lou! Hit it!
We have here, Andy, that was made for us by...
Serving 18 months in the Bonfire Army, a man... That son, when you showed up here, you didn't have enough skills to dial a goddamn phone. But under our watchful eye...
You're like, I'm from Jersey. Jersey! Only steers, queers, and program directors come from Jersey.
That's gross, brother. This ain't terrestrial radio.
We received, you know, as a gift, the Bonfire flag. And we are going to ceremoniously fold this... Like we're at a military funeral. Because in many ways, Andy, you're dead to us. So.
I mean, you're 4 to 6. You're just alive and wounded.
Come on, Dan. You know how to do this. Is this mic on? I think we're going to. This is.
I should
emotional.
Go outside. So it's on the outside.
Ah, you're right. You're right. I'm an idiot. Okay, it's this thing. Were you a Boy Scout? Do we wait? I think one more over. It's going to be a really small rectangle.
Okay.
And then I'm going to flick it to him like a paper football.
Yeah, kick it. Oh, here it goes.
Oh, this is very... Andy, are you crying?
Yes. You better be crying, motherfucker, because you're dead to us.
To us, you're dead. This is it, the kiss of death.
Jacob's going to go, you want to know why my phone charges so quick now? Because I use a dead man's charger. There it is. Now just wing it out.
I have to do the tuck. You gotta do the tuck after this. I'm a bit of a perfectionist.
I mean, you know what, Jay? I just learned something about Jay. He's got some fucking folding skills. This motherfucker's an origami-making motherfucker.
Merc face.
Yes.
This is yours, my friend.
Thanks, man.
Throw it away when we're not looking.
Ever.
Just don't do it with Christine in the room, because she's taking you leaving really hard.
Christine's a bit of a mess for days. We love you, Andy. We're going to miss you a lot, buddy.
Me too, man. Thank you, guys. Honestly, it's...
Yeah, well, anyway, the world keeps turning. And
anyways,
Dan Soder's going to be at the Laugh It Up in Poughkeepsie. No, please, Mark Face.
Yeah, guys. Guys, let's be serious about this. Guys, let's be serious about this. I kind of ended a little too early.
No, I thought Merc Face was going to give it an emotional.
No, like when I learned my lesson. I know. Yeah, it's
like, when you say goodbye before they're out of the car, and you still got like 2 minutes to drive.
We have plugs still.
Well, I can tell you this: Big J Oakerson. Big J Oakerson is going to be at the Sacramento Punchline this weekend, Thursday, May 11th through Saturday, May 13th. Go get tickets at BigJComedy.com. And then go to CISO.com to watch all of What's Your Fucking Deal Season 2. Go do that, please.
And, of course, let's also say again that Mark Norman's New Hour special, Don't Be Yourself, premieres on Comedy Central Friday, March 12th at midnight. And you can also hear him hosting The Drive Home earlier that day at 5:30 East, 5 West, with his guest, hopefully a sober Greg Stone. And let's not forget, most importantly, Dan Soder is going to be at the Laugh It Up in Poughkeepsie. That's New York, Poughkeepsie, New York, for one night only, Saturday, May 27th. Make sure you get your tickets at the all-new DanSoder.com. And they're going to go fast because...
Oh, man.
Murphy's nothing emotional.
Yes, real quick. Thank you guys so much. It's been the funniest 2 years of my life. I love each and every one of you. I genuinely mean that. And especially thank you to the campers who reach out on my Twitter and Instagram and stuff like that. You guys are the best. But, yeah, man, it's a sad day for me because I do really love the show. And I'm going to miss you guys. But... I'll be around, so.
Yeah.
Well, you know,
but
great.
Thank you, guys. It's been, honestly, it's been the best.
I wouldn't worry about it. The campers are all still going to follow you.
Yeah. No, definitely. You'll definitely, you'll take that heat with you to the next show.
I'm sure the Apollo fans are really big on coming out to comedy clubs.
Sure, sure. Sure, you're going to have a loose environment in that studio like you do right here.
Andy, we wish you the best of luck, buddy.
We love you, buddy.
Just not in that time slot.
Yeah. Campers, we love you.
We love y'all, and we'll catch you next week on an all-new Bonfire.
Merc Faceless Bonfire. Thanks for listening. And, yeah, I barehanded a baseball that was shot right at my face today. So do I feel on top of the world? You're goddamn right I do. Merc Face, I love you.